Hi there, I'm Mike. What I have for you today is a double feature review. What I have here is Star Wars The Black Series BT-1 and 000. Hasbro went from having a drought of Star Wars The Black Series figures into having just an absolute ton, and have taken forever to get this wave out, but this is it. This is the end of the wave, and I just wanted to kind of push them out into one quick review, two figures in one, because they're basically an inseparable pair anyways. So let's go ahead and take a look at a picture of them while I read the bio on the back of the boxes. A hostile astromech droid, BT-1 works with Dr. Aphra alongside the protocol droid 000 on destructive missions. The black metal plated droid is heavily armed with flamethrowers and other destructive weapons. Activated by Dr. Aphra, 000 or 000 is a droid programmed for etiquette, protocol, and translations, but also specializes in interrogation and torture. With his fluency in a droid language unique to the Target Initiative Labs, the dark silver-plated droid reactivates an assassin astromech droid BT-1. So here we have them out of the package, and rather than taking, you know, twice as long to do these, I'm going to try to get to these as fast as possible, because it also seems like you guys like it when I do the quick and dirty reviews. So, starting with the looks. These two droids make up a trio that includes Dr. Aphra, my previous review. While all three made their first appearance in the Darth Vader comics, unlike Dr. Aphra, the looks for these have stayed pretty constant. Based on his comic looks here, BT-1 is a Blastomech droid, or a modified R5. He looks pretty spot on from how he does in the comic, including his weird gun mouse antler ear things. It's always looked a little goofy to have guns coming off of him, but that's what it looks like in the comic most of the time. On the other hand, we have 000, who basically just looks like C-3PO, but, you know, he'll kill you. Both of them look like they stepped right out of the pages of the comic, so I'm gonna give them the full point for looks. Moving on to accessories, starting with BT-1. Out of the package, he's got his guns ablazing. I guess his accessories are his boring alternate stuff. The sides of his legs are removable, so if you want to put on normal panels to make him look like a normal droid, you can, but what's the fun in that? Same thing with the guns on the top. They are removable, as well as the little outer panels. So if you want to give him more of a normal look, you absolutely can, but again, why? Why would you do that to him? Up on his head, he's got a little minigun kind of laser blaster thing. It is articulated and it does move back and forth. On the other side, he has this kind of, I don't know, it's like a missile pod kind of thing. It's on an armature, so it kind of moves up and down and back and forth. Some other non-removable accessories, but I'm still counting them as accessories because I have no idea where else they would go. He's basically just the body of an R2-D2 unit, so the doors open and his little kind of armature things do swing out, and that's kind of neat because he's an astromech droid at heart. He also does have an extendable third leg that you can lower by twisting his head around, thereby again giving you multiple display options. If you want him to be a bipod or a tripod, you have that option. Moving on to 000 here, he comes packaged with his murder hands. So for his accessories, they gave him regular hands. If that's the kind of way you want to live your life, giving a murder droid non-murder hands, you live your life the way you want. But for me, in my house, he's gonna have syringe hands till the day I die. Except for one word of caution, I would say be careful of his little saw blade thumb. It is a little bit on the weak side. I've had mine bend a little bit, so just kind of baby it a little bit if you do pull it off and put it on. You can't swap them out as simply as just pulling the wrist off and popping the appropriate hand back on. His alternate hands are molded to hold things if you want to. One even has a trigger finger. So if you want to give him a gun, you can. But again, I much prefer murder hands. So between the two of them, they come with the most accessories of any droid available so far. The only one that really beats BT-1 is the original R2. And 000 here is the protocol droid to come with the most accessories so far. So because of that, I'm going to give them the full point for accessories. I really can't think of anything else they should have come with, and they come with a decent amount. You got a lot of options for display, which is exactly what I want from accessories. Let's move on to articulation. Let's take a look at that real quick.
BT's head moves side to side. His guns can move like this. This gun can move like this and like this. His leg can move all the way around, but this gets in the way. He has a hinge at his feet and wheels on the bottom, as well as a hinge on his third leg, with this being BT's widest stance with both his feet flat on the ground. Triple Zero's head moves side to side. It moves forward that far, back that far. His arm can move out that far. It can move all the way around. It has an upper bicep swivel, as well as this hinge at the arm. There's a hinge at the wrist, as well as a swivel. He has a slight swivel at the torso. It moves forward this far, back pretty far. His leg moves forward this far, back not at all. He has a single jointed knee, a hinge at the ankle, as well as a rocker. With this being Triple Zero's widest stance, with both his feet flat on the ground.
So a lot of the articulation problems with these are just sort of inherent with the designs of the characters. BT here, the only real negative thing I have about him is to lower that third leg, you have to spin the head around, which limits the posing of the head. They're tied together. One doesn't move without the other, and that can get a little frustrating and annoying. Other than that, he's got ankle tilt on both his little wheelie pod things on all three of his legs. So if you want to get him in that classic kind of tripod rolling pose, it's easy to get him there, and he looks fantastic either way. Triple Zero here uses the 4LOM body slash the newer C-3PO bodies. The biggest upgrade from this in the original C-3POs are in the arms. He does have an upper bicep swivel now, as well as an articulated elbow, which is something the first two C-3POs didn't have. Other than that, the best way I can really describe his articulation is it's stiff. That being said, he's a protocol droid. That's kind of how they are. Unless you're watching Attack of the Clones with the CGI C-3PO who's flying around the droid factory, C-3PO didn't really do much other than walk around very stiffly because it's a guy in a suit, and that is translated very well here in the articulation we have here. So I'm not going to dunk it too much, but there are a couple little flaws here, and the articulation of Triple Zero is a little stiff, so I'm going to give it a 0.75. Moving on to paint, sculpt, and detail, both of them are sort of molded or painted in like a dark kind of gray material, which again matches what you see in the comics, so that's not a problem. BT here has a little bit of weathering on the sides of his head, but not very much at all. He does have a lot of silver panel lining around a lot of his little panels, I guess. That's where panel lining goes. The paint that is there is laser sharp. There's really no paint bleed over that I can see. The real big colorful piece on him is that middle eye he has. It's got a gloss finish and a gradient inside to give it a really cool lifelike feature. It's molded from head to toe pretty well, but 80% of this is basically just an R2-D2 body with a new head sculpt. Moving on to Triple Zero here, again, he's got that kind of dark gray molded plastic, although he has a lot more silver weathering. I actually think it looks pretty decent here. His eyes are translucent, and he has a lot of detail molded into the metal plating, especially in the wires at his midsection. It's molded and painted with a lot of great detail. The biggest problem I have with these, and it's not necessarily a problem with these two specifically, it's any protocol droid and astromech droid in this line. Both of them are too small, and that's really the fault of Hasbro when they created the original C-3PO and R2-D2. Probably the original R2-D2, because they had to create the C-3PO to sort of match it. They have to look good together. But both of them, in my opinion, are just a little on the small side. But despite their mostly reused bodies and slightly smaller than I'd like stature, I'm gonna go ahead and give them a 0.75 because the paint they do have, the sculpting they do have, I really do think it looks pretty good. Moving on to want and availability, the want was there the moment they appeared in the comics. These are two of the best things to come out of the new Star Wars EU. I love their characters. Sure, a cynical might say, oh, they're just an evil C-3PO and R2-D2, so creative. But you know what? Any protocol droid is basically a C-3PO that's a different color. I mean, one's bound to be evil. Why not this one? In terms of availability, both of these were available in the previous wave. No, that's not right. The previous wave. Despite two new waves coming out sooner, you can still find these in stores if you really want to, or online. They're not super hard to find. They're number 88 and 89 in the line respectively. If you really want it, I suggest getting on it. You can probably find them at GameStop or online or someplace. I've actually seen them at Target recently myself. So I'm gonna give them the full point. The availability wasn't too hard to find, and I definitely wanted them. So my final score on these is about a 4.5 out of 5. I really do enjoy these figures. They look fantastic in my collection. So if you want more droid representation on your shelves or you're a fan of the newer Star Wars comics, I recommend picking them up. Even if you don't care for the Marvel comics, I think they look good on the shelf. And it's always kind of fun to have extra droids just kind of in the background of your pictures or just kind of hanging out on your shelf. It really kind of brings it to life. It adds a little bit more character to it. So that's it for my review of both BT1 and Triple Zero. Let me know what you thought. Leave a comment down in the downstairs area. I love to read and respond to those. I'd also like to take a moment to thank my Patreon supporters that support me at the Black Series level or higher. Thank you so much, guys. It does mean a lot to me. If you want to get your name on the screen, go ahead and check out my Patreon. If you don't care about Patreon or don't want to spend any money, I get that. There are a couple different ways you can support my channel down in the downstairs area, up to and including liking, sharing, and subscribing. That stuff really does make a difference to the channel, and it's free. But that's it. Thanks so much for getting this far, and I'll see you later. Bye.